Imagine it's evening and you're heading home after a hard day at work. Your foremost desire is either having a cup of hot tea, coffee, or even a mug of chocolate as per your own choice in your comfortable room, or just lying down doing nothing in your cozy bed. And while you're still sorting out the chores in the hierarchy on reaching home, you realize that you are stuck behind a slow-moving car. Worse is the scenario when instead of a four-wheeler, it is a donkey cart, merrily trotting on the road with the rider looking around in every nook and corner, suddenly interested in everything happening around and in no mood of leaving space for you to move on. Imagine that frustration when you are at the height of your exhaustion and despair, since you cannot honk horns on the course. After all, it's a donkey cart. And while donkeys do sound like horns, they don't understand horns. Fellow Toastmasters and guests, the reason behind the sharing this scenario with you is not to tell you that once upon a time I've ridden a donkey cart, but yes, a very similar ride. Our dear Suzuki FX. It was no ordinary car. In fact, it was our little spaceship, hovering and lurking around in the streets of Karachi with the speed of light. Provided that that speed of light was 3 into 10 meters per second instead of 3 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second. It was a two-driver ride, in which one of them took over the steering wheel, while the other one had to use both of his hands to actually do the tedious job of operating the gear, which in itself was another item. There was no concept of a second gear after the first gear. Instead, you had to go directly to the third gear. So the sequence goes like, first gear, third gear, third gear, first gear, first gear, second gear, stop. The horn was such that even after pressing it, you were not sure whether the sound came out of the car or out of your vocal cords. You had to be extra vigilant that if the car did not produce the desired sound on pushing the horn, you'd have to call out, honk honk. Literally, there were times when me and my mother-in-law went out shopping, and while I was still struggling with the gear, the clutch, the horn, and so on and so forth, she would pop her head out and would scream, "Hato, bacho, stay out." Imagine the scenario. Two women sitting in the front seat, one actually behind the steering wheel, and the other sitting beside her, screaming at the top of her lungs to stay away. The man or the woman, unluckily crossing the road, either got there started, right there in the middle of the road, or if he had his senses still working, he would run to the other end and cross the road. Now comes another challenge for our Suzuki FX. How to save the startled man and woman in the middle of the road? Easy. Put on the second gear and stop. The clutch was such that even after extending your entire leg, you were not sure whether it was enough. There were times when while turning around the corner, my car took an almost a last breath and sputtered to a stop. The reason being, the clutch wasn't pushed to its utmost satisfaction. As a result, what I got to hear from the drivers behind me couldn't be repeated here. When I got married, this Suzuki FX proved to be my capricious in-law, to which I had to get accustomed, in whose good books I had to come into. Every morning before setting out for university, it was shiningly polished in the hope that maybe it would brighten up my day instead. Care was taken that whenever coming up from my street towards the main road, there was no car at least at a mile's distance from my dear FX. What if Her Royal Majesty took offense to that and refused to budge? Hydration is very important. And for that, I kept a few water-free bottles always in my car. Not for myself, but for our little dear Minot. The only thing that I didn't do was to put garlands of roses around it, which obviously I would have done if asked for. I know, fellow Toastmasters and guests, that now you must all be wondering that what made us stick to it for so long. The reason being the same as why do we stick to our spouses? There is no alternative. Okay, let's erase it and restart. The reason of our sticking to our Suzuki FX was that it was the safest ride one could have taken while living in Karachi. Nobody would have noticed even a bride sitting inside on her way from the beauty parlor to the wedding venue, provided that it moved on swiftly, stopping only at its destination. Finally, in 2009, we got rid of it. Oops, sorry. Sadly, in 2009, she left us. May her soul depart in peace. And 1,000 pieces. Even today, whenever eyes well up in remorse of her, one of us become that gear producing those heart-wrenching sounds that were once stereotypical of our Suzuki FX, while the other one minds operating the steering. Who said love is rational? Love is way more complicated, and for our Suzuki FX, it was far more complicated than one can think of. It was like our own children. We would get offended, we would even scold them for doing something mischievous. But in the end, we would never tolerate any other person saying something bad to them. This is what our relation would remain with our Suzuki FX, and this we will always remember whenever we see an FX moving in the streets.